ओके लेट्स सी नाउ न्यूमेरिकल नंबर 8 ऑफ फर्स्ट चैप्टर एक्सरसाइज क्वेश्चन नंबर 8 लेट्स सी हाउ टू सॉल्व दिस न्यूमेरिकल टू पॉइंट चार्जेस क्यू ए इक्वल टू 3 माइक्रोकूलम एंड क्यू बी इक्वल टू -3 माइक्रोकूलम आर लोकेटेड एट 20 सेंटीमीटर अपार्ट इन वैक्यूम सी हियर 3 डेटाज आर गिवन टू अस एंड एंटायर सिस्टम इज पुटिंग इन अ वैक्यूम ओके रिमेंबर दिस थिंग केयरफुली नाउ वी हैव टू क्वेश्चन इन दिस न्यूमेरिकल फर्स्ट वन वॉट इज द इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड एट मीट पॉइंट ओ ऑफ द लाइन जॉइनिंग लाइन ए बी जॉइनिंग द टू चार्जेस एंड द सेकेंड क्वेश्चन इज इफ नेगेटिव टेस्ट चार्ज ऑफ मैग्नेट्यूड 1.5 इंटू 10^-9 कूलम इज प्लेस्ड एट दिस पॉइंट वॉट इज द फोर्स एक्सपीरियंस्ड बाय द टेस्ट चार्ज ओके सो लेट्स सी हाउ टू सॉल्व As per the question, first of all, let's draw the diagram. So, point A having +3 microcoulomb charge. Remember, while we have this type of data, we must have to convert it into basic quantity. So, QA equal to we have 3 × 10^-6 coulomb charge. Similarly, point B has -3 microcoulomb charge. So let us convert this thing is also this thing also in coulomb. So it is -3 × 10^-6 coulomb. Okay, midpoint somewhere over here we have. So from A to O we have 10 cm and O to B we have 10 cm. Means total distance lining join are 20 cm that we are considering over here like this. Okay, now let's solve the first problem. Distance between two charges AO, AB equal to 20, AO and OB equal to 10 cm. Now let us consider net electric field experience at point O, which is equal to E. Okay, now as per the theory, last time we saw the theory and base of the theory we have electric field okay electric field formula we have E equal to KQ upon R square so by using this formula we will try to solve this sort out this numerical now K means 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught as you know that we can replace this value so many times we are directly considering value of this over here so K equal to we have 9 × 10^-9 SI unit QA that we have 3 × 10^-6 coulomb and R square remember this thing is given in centimeter so 10 × 10^-2 means in meter into whole square okay by considering this value first electric field due to one QA charge that we will get this one along the OB direction okay similarly go for electric field number 2 for QB charge by using same formula KQB upon R square so you will just we will have to put values over here and finally over here your answer is 2.7 × 10^-6 Newton per coulomb along OP direction but here since magnitude of this charge is negative so over here we will consider negative charge particle now as per the superposition principle net electric field over here remember positive means radially outward and negative means radially inward so net resultant electric field here we will considering only magnitude of that field so we are going to add okay of net electric field at point O okay so E1 plus E2 by using superposition principle putting magnitude of E1 plus E2 over here the total answer will be 5.4 × 10^-6 Newton per coulomb along OB direction so this is first answer okay this is first answer it's a very easy hope you understand this answer now second question we have if a negative test charge of magnitude 1.5 × 10^-9 coulomb is placed at this point what is the force experienced by the test charge so over here let's see basic equation of electric field we have force per unit charge so answer of force equal to we have QE okay so by using this concept let us try to solve second question so test charge over here already given to us and at midpoint O we have to find out force. So force experienced by the test charge that we are considering as F, therefore F equal to QE. So Q equal to given 1.5 into 10 raised to 9 coulomb, and E we already found at point O, midpoint, which is 1.5 into 10 raised to 6. Okay, just calculate whatever you have. That is your homework for calculation. Do it at home and final answer you will get this one. Okay, now as you know that force is a vector quantity, so you must have to indicate direction. The force is directed along the line OA as per the direction of electric field. Okay, you just consider it. This is because the negative test charge is repelled by the charge placed at point P but attracted towards point A. Okay, so this is the simple reason of force. So that's all for today. This is your final answer. Thank you very much. In next video we will see some new numericals. Till then, that's all for today. Now let's have a simple look of question number 8. Just go through it and write, try to sort out by your own. And if you have any questions, feel free to ask me anytime. Just WhatsApp me, I will reply you definitely. Till then, thank you very much.